Hey everyone, Brady from Texturelabs.org here. In this video, we're going to build some animated 80s style Chrome in Adobe After Effects. And I think the best way to get started is to first mention how this effect functions, because it's really a combination of two specific things. First, creating a black and white kind of shaded version of our typography, and then remapping the colors. We're going to do that using the colorama effect. That creates this illusion of reflections rather than highlights and shadows. And by getting just the right black and white shading under that colorama gradient ramp, we can get some really specific, really great details to show up as Chrome. So I've got a comp here that I'm gonna get started in. I'm gonna drop in this night sky image just to give us a background to work against. But most importantly, we're gonna need a live text layer. And I also need a duplicate of this text layer. So one of these layers, the one on the bottom, I'm gonna use to create the front faces of the letters. So I'm gonna rename this layer to face. And the one on top is gonna be for the beveled edges. I'll call it bevel. It's really helpful to separate these and be able to address them as two different elements. So the face layer can be any color text, white will be just fine. But for this bevel layer, I do specifically need this to have a black fill color with a white stroke. And the width of this stroke is going to be the width of the beveled chrome edge. I'm going to go with about 6 pixels. Then let's turn off the bevel layer for now and get started on the face with a few simple effects. The purpose of these effects will be apparent once we get them all on there, so just bear with me as I add things. First, I need a solid composite effect, but I need the opacity setting on this effect down at about 50%. Then I'm gonna add a gradient ramp effect. I'm gonna bring the top and the bottom points of the gradient to roughly match the top and the bottom of the letters, leaving the black on top and the white on the bottom. But I want the black to actually have 1% brightness, and I'm gonna change the white to be 99% brightness. So these are now actually just shy of pure black and pure white. Okay, next effect is another solid composite, this one with completely default settings, and then a fast box blur effect. For now, I'm gonna set this to about 10 pixels. So these four effects give us a gradient inside of the letters and a gradient in the background. But by adjusting the opacity of the first solid composite effect, we can control how much of the gradient shows up in the background. Actually, more importantly, how much of the gradient shows up in these soft edges on the letters. So just keep in mind, we can adjust how soft these edges are, and we can adjust how much of the gradient shows up in them. Okay, we are now ready for the colorama effect. Going to apply that and just leave it at its default settings for a moment. Let's add one more effect, the set matte effect. That's just gonna crop things back to the original shape of the layer. And you can start to get a sense of what we have going here, these colors that are kind of bending through the letters, but we need to customize the colorama effect. So for the output cycle, first, I'm gonna get rid of the rainbow colors and just use this ramp gray preset. That's gonna give us just a basic black and white gradient ramp. Then on the input phase, I'm gonna wanna use phase shift and rotate this exactly 180 degrees. That's gonna give us the beginnings of the chrome effect, but let's dial in a little bit more custom color. So we're probably gonna want some sky blue color. Now, this circular format makes it a little tough to visualize what's happening here, but the way these colors map to our chrome reflection is that this is the start of the gradient. This is the ground. It goes up, up, up. This is the horizon, and then this is the top of the skies. But just by experimenting a little bit, you can get a sense of where the colors are. So maybe we want a little bit more navy blue in the darker areas. Now this curvature on the edges of the letters, this is where we had that lighter, blurry gradient on the edges of the letters. So we can adjust the fast box blur to push that curve inwards or outwards. And the amount of curvature depends on this very first solid composite effect. By bringing the opacity up or down, we can get more or less of that curve happening. So these things can be adjusted depending on what kind of font we're using, how thick the letters are, or how flat you want that front surface to look. Now, for this face layer, I do want to throw in just one more optional effect. What I'm going to do is put a fractal noise effect and have it applied just before the colorama. So that makes everything go kind of haywire, but I'm gonna set the blending mode of the fractal noise to soft light, bring the complexity down to just 2, and then I can bring down the opacity of the fractal noise and leave just enough to bring some irregularity into that horizon line. Gives it a little bit more of this suggestion of like a landscape instead of that perfectly flat horizon. I'm going to leave that at about 30% opacity. This fractal noise is also something that we can possibly animate when it comes to giving this chrome some motion. Now you'll notice this horizon line has no anti-aliasing. This crunchy edge is a little bit of an eyesore. There are two things we can do to clean this up. Number one, in the colorama effect, this threshold between the black and white at the horizon, we can spread these points out just a little bit. That's just gonna give it a little bit of a softer transition from black to white. Additionally, if we change the project settings from 8-bit to 16-bit with an option or alt click in the project panel here, that's going to really help to make that transition nice and smooth. However, it does more than double the render time, so let's just leave that at 8-bit for now, and I'll see if I can remember to switch it once we've got everything dialed in. Okay, believe it or not, the face of the letters is the hard part. We can now move on to the bevel layer, which is actually a little bit simpler. So this layer, black type with a white stroke, but the first thing I'm gonna do is use the generate fill effect to fill this with white. Then to create the beveled shading, we could do that with the CC glass effect, but making this a much more minimal effect, first of all, by bringing the displacement down to zero. We also wanna take the surface from the alpha channel. Then in the shading, we're gonna want 0 ambient, 100 diffuse, and 0 specular. Now, one really nice thing about CC glass, as opposed to something like a bevel emboss layer style, is in the light settings, the ability to switch the light type. If I switch this over to a point light, I can move around the light source, really get much more interesting highlights and shadows. This is also gonna give us some great details when it comes to animating. Now, I am gonna wanna apply colorama to this layer the same as we did before, but the way that colorama maps the values, I actually first want to invert this layer. The sky values in our chrome actually come from the dark colors, so we want the highlights to be dark. Okay, then we're ready for the colorama effect, so what I'm gonna do is just copy the effect we already have set up on the prior layer and paste it onto this layer, which is giving us the right effect, but to make this one extra chromey, in the output cycle repetitions, I'm gonna bring that up to 2. But now, since we've doubled the output cycles, we need to cut the phase shift in half. So the phase shift is gonna go to 90. Okay, looking pretty shiny, but we just wanna use the chromey edges of this layer. So I'm gonna use the set matte effect again. But in this case, use the luminance channel for the matte. So what that does is take the original white stroke and use it as a luma matte, leaving us just the beveled edges. So we've got our face layer and our beveled edge. Here's a nice thing about separating them. On the bevel layer, we can give it its own glow effect. I'm gonna switch the glow colors over to A and B colors, and we'll give the B color a little bit of a warm white color. I'll bring up the threshold to 90 so it only picks up the brightest areas. Maybe we'll take the radius up to about 20 and the intensity up to 7. And this would probably be way too much glow if it was on top of all the letters, but it's kind of cool just to have these really bright highlights just on the beveled edge. All right, that is the basic setup for our chrome, but we are in After Effects, so let's bring this thing to life with some animation. And it really doesn't take much. First of all, on the bevel layer, CC glass effect, we can animate the light position. So maybe we can start by setting a keyframe with the light at the top left corner of the comp. And then over the course of a few seconds, I'll just move it over to the top right corner. And that creates some nice activity on the edges. And then animating the chrome on the face of the letters, there are kind of two main things we can do. We can animate the evolution on the fractal noise. That's just gonna bring some kind of random movement into the reflections. And we can also animate the position of the gradient map. So maybe we can set some keys where at the beginning, the horizon line is kind of at the bottom of the letters, and it slowly ends up moving toward the top of the letters. This works particularly well if your type is only on screen for a few seconds, because once the horizon line gets toward the top of the letters, there's not necessarily a good place to go from here. But this does make a nice little 5-second animation. And then from here on out, it's all about refining the color, maybe customizing it with a few little details. One really cool detail is to get some lens flares in here. And we could do that in a really lo-fi way just by bringing in an image of a lens flare. I actually added some new lens flares to the Texturelabs site not long ago, so I will link below to this. Because this one is only this little spike ball shape, we just animate the scale on it. Maybe it goes from 0 to 12%, back to 0 in 10 frames or so, with an ease on that middle keyframe. I'm gonna set it to screen mode and find kind of a nice highlight to tie that into. That's gonna look like this. And then we may as well just make a bunch of copies of this lens flare, kind of scatter them around the timeline. And for each one, I'm just gonna find a highlight on a beveled edge to kind of line it up with and motivate one of these little flares to happen. Then we might wanna refine and adjust the color of the chrome, so maybe to match other elements in the composition. So if I have some additional typography in here that has a bright red glow to it, well, maybe we would want to introduce a little bit of that red color into the beveled edge chrome color. Then I'm going to parent all of these layers to that very bottom text layer. We can put in just a few keyframes on the scale property of that layer, maybe a few keyframes on the starry background. Give things kind of a fake drift backwards. I think it makes a little bit more sense that the chrome reflections are changing if the type has even just a little bit of movement. I am remembering to switch the project back over to 16-bit. And finally, let's just give it a single adjustment layer and try to make things look a little bit more analog with maybe one more glow effect, just a very faint, very large glow. Then a little noise, 5% noise. We'll make it nice and soft and blurry with some Gaussian blur at 4 pixels. And finally, an unsharp mask effect to kind of shrink wrap it all back together. I kind of like the look of overdoing it on unsharp mask, 200 on the amount and 3 on the radius in this case. And that is our finished piece. However, it really is a simple enough setup that we can very easily continue to experiment. This is still live text, so we can change fonts, which gives things a completely different character. Try out different colors in the chrome. There are just lots of different places to take this. All right, I hope you enjoyed this video. I will include a link below to those lens flare elements and the starry background if you want to bring those into a project. More on the way from the Texturelabs channel. Thanks for watching, and I will see you next time.